بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Imagine if you and I have a quality that is not only beloved to Allah and His prophets, but one that brings about wisdom, fulfillment of wishes, acceptance of deeds, as well as courage and protection from all the fears in the world. That's right. These are some of the immensely powerful impacts of ikhlas, known as sincerity, derived from Islamic teachings. Every Muslim knows the importance of doing everything for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and not practicing what is known as minor polytheism, i.e. ostentation and showing off. Intention is pivotal in Islamic teachings, and working towards being a sincere person is a tremendously important objective for a successful believer. The question, however, is, how do I know if I'm sincere? What qualities must I have to be sure that I do everything for the sake of God and not for others? Here are four highlighted in Quran and Hadith. Number one, not seeking praise or approval from others. This is highlighted in many narrations. Naturally, in our lives as human beings, we desire the attention and praise of others, as it makes us feel worthy and cherished. For many, it's a source of happiness when someone showers praise on us. However, a key sign of a mukhlis, sincere person, is that they don't do anything seeking appreciation. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is narrated to have said, "A sincere deed is one that you don't want to be praised for except by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala." But can we accept praise if it's given by people? Yes, as long as we're not actually doing things for the praise. Note, these days, a dangerous point related to this is the likes button we get on social media platforms where people post seeking approval of others. Let us be wary of the shaitan online. Number two, being more active in public but lazy in private. Sometimes we only do things if others are watching, or we know we will get encouragement or gratitude. A real test of a sincere person is how active towards righteous deeds they are when alone, and no one is aware or is watching them. For example, performing recommendatory prayers such as Salatul Layl, the night prayers, or giving charity when no one is aware. Of course, exceptions do exist, such as having the intention of encouraging others, but we mustn't let the shaitan use this to adulterate the real intention, that is, doing it for God and for God only. Number three, we'll only do more if praised, and if not praised, we'll do less. Imam Ali alayhi salam says in a hadith that a sign of an insincere person is their productivity and deeds depend upon words of others. Without praise, they feel lazy or lethargic and not motivated. With praise, they push themselves more, reminding themselves of how people love them. The story of ikhlas in Islam, remember, is seeking the pleasure of God. We need to be self-motivated by appreciating the unmatched and unparalleled bounties of the Almighty subhanahu wa ta'ala, and that everything is in His hands. Sadly, we forget this sometimes, and hence the narration says, on the day of Qiyamah, judgment, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says to such people, "Go and seek your reward from those whom you sought to impress in this world." Number four, four superb qualities of a believer seeking ikhlas is mentioned in a hadith by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi wa sallam. He is reported to have said, the signs of a sincere person are submission of the heart, submission of the senses, limbs, doing good, and preventing wrong. This means that a true sincere person watches what they're doing, is fully observant of the fact that God the Almighty is watching what they're doing, and is empowered through ikhlas to serve others purely to attain the pleasure of the Creator. Gaining sincerity and remaining sincere is a lifelong journey that we should all undertake. It's certainly not a switch we can turn on, but rather a struggle we should all try and implement step by step, and most certainly Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless and support us. Remember, at the same time, it's very easy to practice showing off and ostentation. And as the Holy Prophet, peace and blessings be upon him and his family, famously said, ostentation, riya, it's like watching and seeing an ant sit on a rock on a dark night. How difficult that is. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to become mukhlisin, sincere individuals in His path.